In this tutorial, you take a look at controlling viewport quality, especially when it comes to textures and background images. Viewport feedback has come a long way in 3ds Max. This can be mostly seen in the relatively new realistic mode, where you can now display real-time feedback of textures, light effects, and shadows. The scene named vpquality.max scene here is a good example. It shows two square planes mapped with blueprints of a World War II airplane to aid with modeling. You can clearly make out the textures, shadows as seen in the top view, and ambient occlusion effects in the perspective view after a refresh. This kind of feedback is mostly welcome, but not always helpful. For modeling purposes, as is the case here, you may opt to remove shadows from the top view, for example. This can be done by disabling shadows in realistic mode, or you can revert to the old and familiar shaded mode. What's more significant in this case is the bitmap quality of the blueprint if you are to use it to model. From a distance, it looks fairly reasonable, but as you zoom in, it may start to break. The fighter plane lines become blurry and jagged as you start looking into the details. To fix this problem with older versions of 3ds Max, you would invoke the Preferences dialog. In the Viewports tab, under Display Drivers, you would normally use the Configure Driver option to increase the quality of the bitmaps in use. This option is now grayed out when the newer Nitrous driver was introduced. This doesn't mean the option to increase quality has gone away, merely that it's been relocated. Cancel the Preferences dialog, and then click the plus sign in the top left corner of any viewport. Choose Configure Viewports, and then go to the Display Performance tab. The relocated options for image quality are in the top area. The two most important options are for texture maps, which are bitmaps used in material definitions, and other images you plan to use as environment backgrounds. Here you can enter the memory allocation you want to reserve for these options. The numbers that you punch in also have to do with the performance of your system and mostly your graphics card. In this case, doubling the texture map's value from 512 to 1024 and clicking the Apply button should yield immediate results. Conversely, bringing the value down to 256 increases video performance, but bitmap quality takes a bad hit in the process. Putting too high a value may not help much with quality, but may affect performance. In this case, setting the texture map value to 1024 or 2048 does not seem to make much of a difference, so it's up to you to find that sweet spot. This can also be affected by the type and resolution of bitmaps you use in the scene. The effect of viewport quality can be even more dramatic with viewport backgrounds. To demonstrate, dismiss the dialog and reset your 3ds Max scene. Using Windows Explorer, browse to the folder where you have downloaded the support files for this tutorial. Drag the montpazier.jpg image into the perspective view. When prompted, use it both as a viewport background and an environment map. If you are in the mood for a bit of history, Montpazier is a 13th century bastide, or fortified town, in the Dordogne region in France. For a while it was home for Eleanor of Aquitaine and Richard II of England. This particular panorama was taken at Place de Cornières, which is the very center of the marketplace. If you're ever in that area, consider visiting on a Thursday, which is the day the market takes place. The experience is well worth it. Back to our project. With the camera hovering over the perspective view, press Alt-W to maximize it. Although the panorama is spherical, it comes in as a 2D background in the viewport. Even so, you can already see that the image quality of the background leaves a lot to be desired. Hold Alt and use the middle mouse button to orbit and adjust your view. Try a test render or two. If you want, increase your render resolution for a better view. You will notice two things. First, the background image in the viewport does not respond when orbiting the view. Second, the rendered backgrounds do not match the viewport background. Again, this is because the viewport background is currently a fixed 2D image, whereas the rendering background is based on a 3D spherical environment. To set the viewport background to match the 3D environment, press Alt-B. In the Viewport Configuration dialog, Background tab, set the background to read the environment you set in the scene, and click OK. The environment was set earlier, at the same time you dragged the bitmap in the viewport. The display in the viewport changes, but if anything, the quality is much worse. Again, this is something that can be adjusted by clicking the plus sign in the top left corner of the viewport. Go to Configure Viewports, Display Performance, and adjust the memory allocation for the viewport background. Here you will see a significant improvement by going from 512 to 1024, or even to 2048 if your graphics card can handle it. This time, as you exit the dialog and try orbiting around, the background will properly update the view. In a perspective view, you can also adjust the field of view and have the background respond to that change. As a last note, remember that viewport quality does not affect final rendering. So based on your system, you can adjust that quality so that it gives you the best trade-off between visuals and performance.